Hello, welcome to GNP Sir channel. If you have subscribed to my channel, I am highly thankful to you. If you have not already subscribed, kindly subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification so that you receive the notification of our videos very fast. Right? So, Vetro-Medical termination of pregnancy is frequently required in dogs, but it is less required in ruminants and horses. Today we are discussing the medical termination of pregnancy in ruminants like cattle, goats, buffaloes and sheep and in horses. Friends, I am Professor Govind Narayan Purohit, your friend. So, Vetro-Medical termination of pregnancy can sometimes be necessary for managing breeding cycles and for maintaining the health. So what could be the reasons for termination of pregnancy? Termination may be required due to accidental breeding, clinical conditions or complications like fetal mummification, hydrops, pregnancy toxemia or periparturient hemoglobinuria when buffaloes, when it becomes very difficult to manage. So termination of pregnancy would be useful. Methods. So what are the methods and what are the doses of the medicines that can be used for pregnancy termination? First, we discuss about cattle and buffaloes. So for cattle and buffaloes, most medicines are similar, and for early gestation 5 to 150 days, one can administer 25 mg of dinoprostromethamine or 500 microgram of clopidogrel, available in different names, intramuscularly. This induces luteolysis and leads to pregnancy termination, with pregnancy being terminated within 24 to 48 hours. For mid to late gestation, 150 to 283 days, use a combination of 500 microgram clopidogrel or 20 to 25 milligram dexamethasone to terminate pregnancy by acting on both luteal and placental progesterone sources. During the end of gestation, last month, a single dose of either 20 to 25 mg of dexamethasone or 500 microgram of prostaglandin F2 alpha given intramuscular can induce parturition within 2 to 3 days, right? And you may repeat the dosage if it is required. For goats, the pregnancy is maintained by the CL for the complete gestation. So 5 to 15 mg of PGF2-alpha or 100 microgram of clopidogrel intramuscular effectively terminates pregnancy at any stage in goats, and the parturition or abortion will occur within 48 hours. Repeat the dose if termination hasn't occurred within 48 hours for goats. For sheep, the pregnancy is maintained by the CL for early period, so early gestation up to 55 days, 100 to 250 microgram of clopidogrel or 10 to 12 milligram of dinoprost may be sufficient for pregnancy termination at this period. But beyond day 55, 15 to 20 milligram of dexamethasone intramuscular can induce parturition by mimicking fetal cortisol increase necessary for labor onset, because the placenta produces sufficient progesterone at this time. Now we talk of methods and dosage in horses. In horses, pregnancy termination is something different from ruminants. During the early gestation, 5 to 34 days, physical methods such as uterine lavage are effective for pregnancies up to 35 days. The prostaglandins are also effective, but use a lower dosage, 10 mg dinoprostromethamine or 250 microgram clopidogrel to cause luteolysis. Prostaglandins have serious side effects in mare, so use cautiously, and overdosage can lead to death of the mare. And single or repeated injections may be necessary, but carefully use the dose. The side effects include perspiration, sometimes salivation. During the mid stage, 35 to 120 days for such pregnancies, 10 mg dinoprost intramuscular every 12 to 24 hours for 3 to 5 days is recommended, but warn the owners about the side effects, of which may be transient. Mares may experience sweating, mild colic, so monitor closely and warn the owner about the serious and potential side effects which may be transient, but sometimes it may lead to problems. During the late gestation, after 4 months, this is a very crucial period as prostaglandins are ineffective and termination of pregnancy at this stage is challenging. And the only means is the manual destruction of the fetal membranes after cervical dilation with PGE2 creams. Some reports say that repeated PGF2 alpha injections may be effective, but they are effective very rarely, only in a few cases. And because of the potential side effects, they are not recommended. So we conclude from today's talk that pregnancy termination is a serious decision that requires professional veterinary guidance. It must be done under professional veterinary guidance. And each animal and pregnancy stage requires a tailored approach for safe and effective outcomes. So you should consult your vet. And thank you for watching and subscribe for more expert insights on animal health and care. Give your likes, give your suggestions, give your comments. See you in the next video. Bye.